El pastor Ramírez va a explicar ahora cuáles son los mecanismos que usa el reino demoníaco para capturar almas durante el Halloween.
So, for the people who are watching, what do Satanists do to celebrate Halloween?
So Halloween is like Good Friday, right? To us, right? Halloween to the devil will be like Good Friday. And then November 1st, which is the Day of the Dead, will be like Resurrection Sunday to us. To us, when I was in the demonic side, when you were doing Resurrection Sunday, I do November 1st, the Day of the Dead. Resurrection means life. The Day of the Dead means death. Halloween means to us, means you know, changing people's identity in the spirit realm, so we can entrap them, and then all hell will break loose in their life and in their marriage and their children, because there's a ripple effect in the demonic side to create that atmosphere, the demonic atmosphere in someone's life when you celebrate Halloween. So when we celebrate Halloween, it's like you celebrating Good Friday.
What would you say to parents who have children that want to celebrate Halloween? Do parents need to be on guard?
I mean, absolutely. It's like you telling the devil, here, I'm gonna put my children on a spiritual altar and sacrifice my children spiritually, because whatever you give the devil's looking for an opportunity to create stronghold, bondages, legal rights over your children. You might dress up a kid and say, oh, I'm gonna dress up like little Ariel, the little mermaid. That's a marine spirit. That's a water spirit. That's what in the demonic world, we call that a water spirit, a marine spirit. Well, I'm gonna dress up like Casper the Friendly Ghost. And I'm using these terms because this is what we think that is harmless. As long as I don't dress my kid as a witch and I don't dress him like a vampire, it's okay. Dress like this Casper the Friendly Ghost is a spirit. It's a ghost in the demonic world. So you changing your children's identity in the spirit realm, where God created your children to be something amazing, awesome, because God has a purpose and a destiny. Now you edit and you alter your children's life, and then the devil will come later to collect the opportunity that you gave him when he was 5, 6, 7, 8 years old. Now your kid is 16, 17, 18, he's on drugs. Your daughter's on drugs, your kid's on drugs, they're not behaving. You say, well, my kids grew up in church. No, but you forgot, go back and backtrack and hit the rewind button. You dedicate them to the devil without even realizing it. Now the devil has a stronghold and own your legal rights and your kids, and your kids are not functioning in a godly way.
I agree. I think we can open doors even completely out of ignorance, and I think seeds can be sown. One of the things I noticed about Halloween and really stuck out to me over all these years, it's really a time of fear. Do you believe that the devil wants to sow seeds of fear into young children?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the movies, horror movies, fear, mind control spirits, you know, all these opportunities. That's why the Bible says protect your eye gate, ear gate, mouth gate, right? Because these are avenues that the devil will capitalize and bring fear. Fear brings torment. That's why kids sometimes, I can't sleep at night because I see demons, I see things, or there's something in my room. Why? Because you have created an atmosphere in your home that you allow things to happen that are ungodly, and you make Jesus Christ uncomfortable in your home, but you made the devil very comfortable.
That's such a good point. Why don't you explain some of the meanings? I'm going to give different things to you, and I want you to explain the meanings behind popular Halloween items. One are pumpkins or jack-o'-lanterns.
Well, pumpkin is a marine spirit called Ochun, in the Santeria religion. And she is the marine spirit that controls the rivers. And her MO, her opportunity for her to operate in the human terms of people is pumpkins. You know, when I did witchcraft, when I was doing dedications and ceremony and rituals in the rivers, I would have to bring a pumpkin, honey, and some other ingredients to make a contract with that demon. So the pumpkin situation in the occult realm, in the spirit of the demonic realm of the spirit, has an attachment to it that you make a legal right when you connect with that situation, or you decorate your house with pumpkins and carve the faces and all these things, that you bring that situation into your home, not realizing the implication and the dangers, the spiritual dangers behind it.
What about gravestones? There's a lot of those in my neighborhood right now.
I'm sure there are. You know, people put gravestone, but if you put a cross, then people be offended, right?
Yeah.
I mean, think about it. If you put a cross, people be offended. Gravestone is a sign of death. You know, it's a sign of death. When you put gravestone, you're saying that you are connecting with the dead. You're connecting with demonic spirits. There was a contract that I had when I was in the demonic world. In order for me to get that contract, to get in, I had to sleep in a cemetery, like 7 days in a cemetery, on a tomb, to get that contract. And it represents graveyards. Gravestones represent these things that looks more like Well, it's harmless. It's just a piece of plastic or it's just a piece of cardboard. But it's what's behind the scenes, what you're celebrating, you're dedicating, and you're making allegiance to. Gravestone represents death. And a lot of people, when they play with these gravestones, what you're doing, you're declaring premature death over your family.
Mm. You know, I was just thinking about it. When you were talking about the gravestones, I was saying they're all over my neighborhood. And I go for walks with my two-year-old, and he hates the decorations because they're scary. And, you know, children are so pure. You know, they can see, he can see that something's wrong and it's not okay. But one of the things I hate about Halloween in this time of year is it takes things that are evil and makes it marketable to young children and to believers. And you know for yourself, it's not good. And yet it's almost like we get comfortable with it because it's around us so much.
But it becomes a norm. And when it becomes a norm, we become acceptable. When you have something that is acceptable, you open doors. We call it the demonic world. When you open door, gateways and portals, you open in the demonic side. And then you get these demons and the deities and these principality, territory from the spirit. You give them rights over your life. Even your young boy, he walks around. He feels something in his spirit. Mm-hmm. I mean, this is a little boy that's been called by God. His hand, the God hand is upon this little boy. God, even though he's little, but he's big in the inside, God is showing him, you know, stay away from these things. That's why he feels eerie. He doesn't feel, he feels uncomfortable. You say, but he's only two. But the Jesus in him is telling him, you don't practice those things. Don't touch those things. Stay away from those things. I believe that in my heart.
Would you say that Satanists fear the devil more than Christians fear God?
We bring the devil into the church by celebrating Halloween, right? Mm-hmm. But you don't see Satanists saying on Good Friday, saying, I can't wait for Good Friday. I want to go to your church. I don't mean, if I would have went to the church as a devil worshiper at the time, at the time that I was a devil worshiper, the devil would have killed me. The devil would have destroyed me because I disrespected him. I did something that was so evil in his eyes that I crossed over to the other side to celebrate Jesus. In other words, he made him jealous and he would kill me. So we come to a place that we celebrate things and we honor things that are ungodly. You know, the Bible says you can't eat for two masters' table. Either you eat from one and hate the other, eat from this one or hate this one. I mean, you have to make up your mind. And it's harmless. You think it's harmless. You know, one thing I've been doing this whole month of October, I've been preaching in Texas. I've been preaching in every Oklahoma city. And I've been doing altar calls. And to my surprise, I've been doing altar calls for people to repent from celebrating Halloween so they can break the legal rights and the strongholds and the bondages in their life. Because now they're living a mediocre Christian life and they'll wonder why. And I've been doing altar calls. And at least 100 to 150 people at the altar repenting from celebrating Halloween.
Wow, that is so amazing. And I can't even believe it. Like you said, that Satanists, they won't go to church and celebrate Good Friday, but you'll see Christians celebrating Halloween. It's just such a crazy thought that we need to be more honoring to God than Satanists are being honoring to the devil. That is just so wild.